Hey people, so in the last video we talked about Realm database and how it benefits developers, especially mobile developers. I specialize in Android development and I use Realm on a day-to-day basis. I'm doing this tutorial for you to see how wonderful Realm is. In this video, we're going to be talking about how to integrate Realm into your application, how to build your database design. And Realm uses just normal plain old Java object design for database. So we have two classes here, Realm Model Example and Example Application. In Realm Model Example, we're going to have our database model, and over in our application, Example Application, we're going to consume that using our Realm transaction. So over here, we're going to go on to build our Realm Model class. So we have our Realm Model example, and we have our Example Application. So right in Realm Model Example, we will be building a simple Java Pojo class. That's plain old Java object for Pojo. So we're going to be building a class with a name and an age, and we get and set its getters and setters. So here we go. And this is like every other Java class. Now, to make it a Realm model, what we need to do is to extend Realm objects. So I'm sure if you're watching this, you should have been acquainted with the Java extends keyword. So we're going to extend Realm object, and voila, there you have it. So what I'm going to do now is to add a constructor so that we don't need to use the getters and setters every time. We can just call a constructor and do that. But let me do that quickly. So that does it. So we have our class ready and Realm database ready to go. So this is just like any other Java, simple Java class you see, except for the fact that it extends Realm objects. So right now we'll go over to our example application. So just like in the previous video where I was planning to use an Android application, I will imitate an Android application here, and I'm going to extend application instead of app compact activity. Twisting my tongue. So I'm going to extend application. I'll override onCreate and initialize Realm. So what I'm doing here is, instead of me creating a whole activity and designing XML, I just want to quickly show you what Realm can do. So I can also initialize Realm in this application class, putting the context, this talking about the immediate context. So now we have initialized Realm, and the next thing is to get an instance of Realm. So what we'll do is realm.getDefaultInstance. You need to do that before you begin to query. So I'm going to use that Realm variable to query my database. Now, before you do a query, or while you're doing a transaction, a Realm transaction, a write operation, because what we want to do is do a write operation now, we surround that operation between transactions, wrapped inside transactions. So what we have is realm.beginTransaction and realm.commitTransaction. Now, whatever you do will be between these two. And if you decide you don't want to commit, you can cancel it. All right, so let's start with our first example. So first, we create a new Realm object using the realm.createObject method. So what this does is it initializes, instantiates and adds a new object to the Realm. Was almost twisted there. So now the argument there is the class of the object to be created. That's what is the argument of the create object method. So now we can now set our age and name. And once we are done with that, and it's inside the commit transaction and begin transaction, that's all. It's inserted into our Realm database. This, my friends, is the simple way to insert a new value into Realm database. Nothing more than this. This does it, and I don't know about you, but I'm really wowed. And the first time I saw it, it was really interesting. But I'll call this example one or method one. I'll show you other methods right away. The second way to insert a value into Realm database is for you to create an object instance first and then use the method copy to realm to add it to a realm. So what we're going to do is that we're going to use the constructor, put the name and the age. That was why I had to use the constructor. And then after that, I use realm.copy to realm. But I'm going to do that inside the transaction. So what happens is that I can do this creation of the instance of the object first outside the transaction. But when I want to copy into realm database, I have to use realm.copy to realm. So I will do realm.copy to realm, and then inside the argument I put user, and then I commit the transaction. So that's that about that. And Realm supports as many constructors as you like, as long as one of them is a public no argument constructor, as was seen in the code. One of them must not have any arguments. So there might be cases where you want to insert more than one object at the same time. So the recommended approach is to use insert or insert or update. I'll talk on that later, but for now, we're just going to use insert. So what we're going to do is create two objects of our Realm Model Example class. So the first object is going to have a name, James, as you can see, and an age, 22. The next object is going to have a name, Charles, and age, 30. So now that we have two objects, instead of creating two different transactions to insert them one after the other, we will just insert this list, and everything is going to be inserted into our Realm database. I'll show you in a second. So like each other previous insertion we have done, we will begin the transaction, insert it, and commit the transaction. So what we're going to do now is to do our realm.begin transaction. Then realm.insert. And in the insert, we're going to impute the users. So you could use this for any other Realm database you have. Probably you might have more than two variables. You could have name, age, sex, address. And this is a very convenient way. So I believe I've given a brief introduction to Realm and how it operates. From here, we'll go on to creating our to-do list. So you can see that there are two constructors here, like I mentioned before. If you're going to use a constructor, there must be one with no arguments. If not, you get an error, an exception. So that's all about this. And in coming videos, we're going to create our to-do list. Wish you guys all the best.